salvación derramó su sangre y resucitó glorioso de su Cristo vivo, el cual vive y reina por los siglos de los siglos.
Lectura del libro del profeta Isaías. He aquí que mi siervo prosperará, será engrandecido y exaltado, será puesto en alto. Muchos se horrorizaron al verlo, porque estaba desfigurado su semblante, que no tenía ya aspecto de hombre, pero muchos pueblos se llenaron de asombro. Ante él los reyes cerrarán la boca, porque verán lo que nunca se les había contado, y comprenderán lo que nunca se habían imaginado. ¿Quién habrá de creer lo que hemos anunciado? ¿A quién se le revelará el poder del Señor? Creció en su presencia como planta débil, como una raíz en el desierto. No tenía gracia ni belleza. No vimos en él ningún aspecto atrayente. Despreciado y rechazado por los hombres, varón de dolores, habituado a sufrimiento, como uno del cual se aparta la mirada, despreciado y desestimado. Él soportó nuestros sufrimientos y aguantó nuestros dolores. Nosotros lo tuvimos por leproso, herido por Dios y humillado, traspasado por nuestras rebeliones, triturado por nuestros crímenes. Él soportó el castigo que nos trae la paz. Por sus llagas hemos sido curados. Todos andábamos errantes como ovejas, cada uno siguiendo su camino. Y el Señor cargó sobre él todos nuestros crímenes. Cuando lo maltrataba, se humillaba y no abría la boca, como un cordero llevado a degollar, como oveja ante el esquilador. Enmudecía y no abría la boca. Inicuamente y contra toda justicia se lo llevaron. ¿Quién se preocupó de su suerte? Lo arrancaron de la tierra de los vivos, lo hirieron de muerte por los pecados de mi pueblo, le dieron sepultura con los malhechores a la hora de su muerte, aunque no había cometido crímenes ni hubo engaño en su boca. El Señor quiso triturarlo con el sufrimiento. Cuando le entregué su vida como expiación, verá a sus descendientes, prolongará sus años y por medio de él prosperarán los designios del Señor. Por las fatigas de su alma verá la luz y se saciará. Con sus sufrimientos justificará mi siervo a muchos, cargando con los crímenes de ellos. Por eso le daré una parte entre los grandes y con los fuertes repartirá despojos, ya que indefenso se entregó a la muerte y fue contado entre los malhechores. Cuando tomó sobre sí las culpas de todos e intercedió por los pecadores. Palabra de Dios.
It is. reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, since we have a great high priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God, let us hold fast to our confession, for we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but one who has similarly been tested in every way, yet without sin. So let us confidently approach the throne of grace to receive mercy and to find grace for timely help. In the days when Christ was in the flesh, he offered prayers and supplications with loud cries and tears to the one who was able to save him from death. And he has heard because of his reverence. Son, though he learned obedience from what was suffered, and when he was made perfect, he became the source of eternal salvation for all who obey him. The word of the Lord.
Why do you strike me?
Then Annas sent him bound to Caiaphas, the high priest. Now Simon Peter was standing there keeping warm, and they said to him,
"You are not one of his disciples, are you?"
He denied it and said,
"I am not."
One of the slaves of the high priest, a relative of one of those whose ears Peter had cut off, said,
"Didn't I see you in the garden with him?"
Again, Peter denied it, and immediately the cock crowed. Then they brought Jesus from Caiaphas to the praetorium. It was morning, and they themselves did not enter the praetorium in order not to be defiled, so they could eat the Passover. So Pilate came out to them and said,
"What charge do you bring against this man?"
They answered and said to him,
"If he were not a criminal, we would not have handed him over to you."
At this, Pilate said to them,
"Take him yourselves and judge him according to your law."
The Jews answered him,
"We do not have the right to execute anyone."
In order that the word of Jesus might be fulfilled, that he said, indicating to the kind of death he would die. So Pilate went back into the praetorium and summoned Jesus and said to him,
"Are you the king of the Jews?"
Jesus answered,
"Do you say this on your own, or have others told you about me?"
Pilate answered,
"I am not a Jew, am I? Your own nation and the chief priests handed you over to me. What have you done?"
Jesus answered,
"My kingdom does not belong to this world. If my kingdom did belong to this world, my attendants would be fighting to keep me from being handed over to the Jews. But as it is, my kingdom is not here."
So Pilate said to him,
"Then you are king."
Jesus answered,
"You say I am a king. For this I was born, and for this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone who belongs to the truth listens to my voice."
Pilate said to him,
"What is truth?"
When he had said this, he again went out to the Jews and said to them,
"I find no guilt in him, but you have a custom that I release one prisoner to you at Passover. Do you want me to release to you the king of the Jews?"
They cried out again,
"Not this one, but Barabbas."
Now Barabbas was a revolutionary. Then Pilate took Jesus and had him scourged. And the soldiers wove a crown out of thorns and placed it on his head and clothed him in a purple cloak. And they came to him and said,
"Hail, King of the Jews."
And they struck him repeatedly. Once more, Pilate went out and said to them,
"Look, I am bringing him out to you so that you may know that I find no guilt in him."
So Jesus came out wearing the crown of thorns and the purple cloak. And Pilate said to them,
"Behold, the man."
When the chief priests and the guards saw him, they cried out,
"Crucify him, crucify him."
Pilate said to them,
"Take him yourselves and crucify him. I find no guilt in him."
The Jews answered,
"We have a law, and according to the law he ought to die, because he made himself the Son of God."
Now when Pilate heard this statement, he became even more afraid, and went back into the praetorium and said to Jesus,
"Where are you from?"
Jesus did not answer him. So Pilate said to him,
"Do you not speak to me? Do you not know that I have power to release you and I have power to crucify you?"
Jesus answered him,
"You would not have power over me if it had not been given to you from above. For this reason, the one who handed me over to you has the greater sin."
Consequently, Pilate tried to release him, but the Jews cried out,
"If you release him, you are not a friend of Caesar. Everyone who makes himself a king opposes Caesar."
When Pilate heard these words, he brought Jesus out and seated him on the judge's bench in the place called Stone Pavement, in Hebrew, Gabbatha. It was preparation day for Passover, and it was about noon, and he said to the Jews,
"Behold, your king."
They cried out,
take him away, crucify him."
Pilate said to him,
"Shall I crucify your king?"
The chief priests answered,
"We have no king but Caesar."
Then he handed him over to them to be crucified. So they took Jesus, and carrying the cross himself, he went to what was place of the skulls, in Hebrew, Golgotha. There they crucified him, and with him two others, one on either side, with Jesus in the middle. Pilate also had an inscription written and put on the cross. It read, Jesus the Nazarene, King of the Jews. Now many of the Jews read this inscription, because the place where Jesus was crucified was near the city, and it was written in Hebrew, Latin, and Greek. So the chief priests and the Jews said to Pilate,
do not write the King of the Jews, but that he said, I am the King of the Jews.
Pilate answered,
what I have written, I have written.
When the soldiers had crucified Jesus, they took his clothes and divided them into four shares, a share for each soldier. They also took his tunic, but the tunic was seamless, woven in one piece from the top down. So they said to one another,
let's not tear it, but cast lots for it to be who it will be.
In order that the passage of Scripture might be fulfilled that says, they divided my garment among them, and for my vesture they cast lots. This is what the soldiers did. Standing by the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdala. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciples there, whom he loved, he said to his mother,
woman, behold your son.
Then he said to the disciples,
behold your mother.
And from that hour, the disciples took her into his home. After this, aware that everything was now finished, in order that the scripture might be fulfilled, Jesus said,
I thirst.
There was a vessel filled with common wine, so they put a sponge soaked in wine on a sprig of hyssop and put it into his mouth. When Jesus had taken the wine, he said,
it is finished.
And bowing his head, he handed over the spirit. Now, since it was preparation day, in order that the bodies might not remain on the cross on the Sabbath, for the Sabbath day of the week was a solemn one, the Jews asked Pilate that their legs be broken and that they be taken down. So the soldiers came and broke the legs of the first and then of the other, one who was crucified with Jesus. But when they came to Jesus and saw that he was already dead, they did not break his legs, but one soldier thrust his lance into his side, and immediately blood and water flowed out. An eyewitness has testified, and this testimony is true. He knows that he is speaking the truth, so that you may also come to believe. For this happened so that the scripture passage might be fulfilled. Not a bone of it will be broken. And again, another passage says, they will look upon him who they have pierced. After this, Joseph of Arimathea, secretly a disciple of Jesus for fear of the Jews, asked Pilate if he could remove the body of Jesus, and Pilate permitted it. So he came and took his body. Nicodemus, the one who had first come to him at night, also came bringing a mixture of myrrh and aloes, weighing about 100 pounds. They took the body of Jesus and bound it in burial cloths along with spices, according to the Jewish burial custom. Now, in the place where he had been crucified, there was a garden, and in the garden a new tomb, in which no one had yet been buried. So they laid Jesus there because of the Jewish preparation day, for the tomb was close by. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise.